Hi, I'm Dave Vernier, and I'm here to show you how to use the digital control unit, the DCU, with Lager Pro. Now, the DCU has been around for a long time, but up until now, it's been used mostly by people who are programmers and writing programs in languages like LabVIEW to do projects. And for example, in this book we have called Engineering Projects with Vernier, we have a lot of projects using the DCU. But recently, we added some functionality to Lager Pro such that you can actually control the DCU and do lots of interesting projects without any programming, just setting up things in Lager Pro. And I'd like to show you an example. Here I have a DCU connected to a LabQuest Mini. Now the DCU has its own power supply. You can either use a LabQuest power supply or a LabPro power supply. You connect whatever devices you're going to control to the DCU. Here in this case I have a LED and a buzzer. And then, in this case, I have a motion detector also connected to the same LabQuest Mini. Now, I've got a Lager Pro running here, and the motion detector is plotting distance, position versus time. If I want to control the DCU, I click on the Setup Sensors option, and then I click on the Digital Control Unit in the control box there, and there's a pull-down for digital output. In that, I can set the activation of the line. So the statement I'm going to use here is activate line one if position is less than, I'll say, a half meter. So it's sort of like building a sentence there. And let's just see what this does. I'll close the dialog. And I'll hit the collect button, and you'll see what you'd expect. That is, the motion detector is plotting distance. If I move closer than a half meter, our LED goes on. So with this addition of the motion detector and the DCU, we're able to make a simple alarm system without much effort at all. There are lots of other possibilities with this. For example, when I was in there configuring the activation, I could have set it up so that the buzzer and the LED go on after a certain time interval, say 10 minutes into an experiment where you want to remember to add some chemicals if you're doing something, or to remind you to turn off something when it's getting tired or something like that. So there's lots of possibilities. Also, if you look at the dialog box, you'll see that there's actually three lines you control. Line one, line two, and line three, and in each case, you can do compound statements. So for example, I could have said, turn on line one when the position is less than a half meter and the time is greater than 10 minutes. So you can do those kind of things. And I've got three lines to control, so I have some real possibilities here. Now, to show that to you and also to have some fun, we're going to show you our Lager Pro controlled tea maker. So let's take a look at our tea maker. First, we have a motor here, which will raise and lower a tea bag above and into the cup there. We have a Vernier infrared temperature sensor here, reading the temperature inside the cup. We have a photo gate here. And then on this side, we have the DCU. And then the DCU is connected over here to the motor via this wire, and also to a LED and buzzer arrangement, just like we had in the earlier part of this video. So in terms of software, we're using Lager Pro, and if you look at this screen, we spent quite a lot of time setting up a kind of a custom tea making file for Lager Pro. We have instructions, we have a photo showing how to connect the tea bag, and we have user parameters which let you set the brewing time of your tea and the serving temperature that you like your tea served at. We have a graph and we have a thermometer. So let's make some tea. If I hit the collect button on Lager Pro, tea bag is lowered. And now I'm going to add some hot water. You should see the temperature going up. And now we're into the brewing time. Now I set the brewing time for 2 minutes. I want to make some fairly weak tea here because I'm trying to speed things up. We're also going to drink it pretty hot also to speed things up. But now we'll see a graph happen, but they'll show slight cooling of the tea, but also we're just waiting out the the time for the 2 minutes. Remember, in LagerPro, I can set a control to turn on a line when the temperature, when the time is greater than a certain limit. When we reach the 2 minute end of the brewing time, the tea bag's lifted out, and we actually use the photogate as a way to mark the right position for it to stop. When the LED is blocked, we stop. That's one of those combined statements. We said when brewing time is done and the photogate is blocked, stop. So now we're going to go through a period where we read the temperature and we watch until the temperature reaches a proper serving temperature. We started at about 70 degrees here, and Celsius that is, and most people don't want their tea that hot, so maybe about 60 degrees or so, that's what I set it for. And when that happens, we'll get the buzzer and the LED going off, indicating it's the proper time for our tea to be served. So the buzzer goes off and the LED is on when the tea is at the proper temperature, and now I think I'll have a sip. So that's our LagerPro tea maker. We've had a lot of fun with it. We think that the combination of the DCU and LagerPro allows some great projects for your students. It's a great way to add STEM to your classroom because all of these have a little bit of engineering to them. And we think you'll have a good time with this. For more information, check out www.vernier.com.